here with Cal Crutchlow, caught up with him at the NEC. How's life, Cal? I mean, obviously a very successful first test out in Portimao 3 weeks ago. Now you've had the time to sort of settle in and think about that. What were you feeling for the future?
I don't know, I've been really, you know, I was really looking forward to riding the little R6 Yamaha at Portimao, and luckily the test went fantastic. We did a good 2 days testing, got through a lot of stuff with the team, and fortunately it came out, you know, with doing reasonable lap times as well, you know, very respectable for the World Supersport pace. So, you know, I was pleased with that straight off, and the bike and team were very good, that we jowled so well, and you know, I've just took a lot of confidence from that, and now just sitting in the off season waiting for the next test. Really, I don't know when we're going to be out again next. Maybe early January, but I'm just getting myself prepared and focused. You know, a lot of hard training, and you know, enjoying a bit of a break. To be honest, I did a lot of stuff this year with, you know, doing the 8-hour and you know, the whole BSB Championship and a couple of the World Superbike as well. So it's a busy time for me this year, but you know, I'm relaxing, but I'm also training hard.
And how's it been jumping back on a Supersport bike? Obviously we've seen the pace was there, no problem, but is it a big transition to jump back to it?
It is, you know, people don't really understand, you know, it just didn't take me long to start going fast, but to change my riding style back to how a 600 should be rode was, you know, a lot different. I was changing gear at 14,000 RPM, which is near enough the same as a Superbike, when, you know, these things rev to 16.5, so the team were wondering why I was changing so early and stuff like that, but I was just thinking that it was gonna blow up, but it, these 600 engines just take so much revs to keep going. It's a fantastic little bike, and you know, I've enjoyed riding it straight away, and no real adjustment at all.
Amazing. And next year's championship's obviously shaping up. You're gonna have some pretty awesome competition. You know, you've got Anthony West coming back from MotoGP. You've got Kenan Sofuoglu back to World Supersport, and he's obviously shown that he's not going to be there messing about after winning in Portimao. Andrew Pitt, double world champion. I mean, you've got some. How are you feeling about that sort of strength of field you're going to be up against?
Yeah, you know, as exactly as you said, it's such a strong field, but I'm up for stuff like that. I like the challenge, I like the battle, and you know, the more people that are tough in the championship, the better for me. You know, I think it'll come down to who wants it the most, and there's, you know, I don't think there's anybody who wants it as much as what I do. So it's going to be a hard year for me learning the circuits, but I'll try my hardest, and that's all we can do. Hopefully we'll come out with some good results, and you know, we'll see where we are in the championship and assess the situation. But yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to the challenge.
Great stuff. Thanks very much, Cal.
Cheers.